Let's create a process to do a basic mathematical calculation. I'll first click the reset button so that we are ready to create and run the next process. In order to do a calculation, we can use the calculation stage, or in short, the calc stage. I'm going to drag and drop the calc stage into the canvas and link it between the start and end. In order to do that, select the pointer and select this link by clicking on it once and hit the delete key. Then select the link tool again and join these stages like this. Now I need to tell Blue Prism what calculation it has to do with this calc stage. So I double click the calc stage and type 3 plus 2 under expression. Then I will name the stage as addition. Now when we run this process, Blue Prism has to store the output somewhere. For this purpose, we have a stage called data item. A data item is basically a container that can store information. This information could be a number, text, date, time, or even an image. This is very similar to a variable that we use in programming languages. So I'm going to drag and drop a data item and I will name it as sum. Then set the data type as number because it is going to store a number and click OK. Now I'll double click the calc stage and here you can see under numbers the data item which we just created has shown up. So I'll simply drag and drop it into this field which says store result in and then click OK. Let me save the process by clicking the save button or pressing the key combination Ctrl S. Blue Prism will prompt you to enter the comments for the summary of changes you have done. This is really important and a good practice to enter comprehensive summary so that you can track what change has happened. I'll enter as addition stage created and click save changes. Now I'm going to click the play button and let's see what happens. Okay, so you can see that the value of sum is 5. So the calc stage has basically added 3 and 2 and then stored the output in the data item sum. All right, now instead of hard coding the values 3 and 2 in the calc stage, let's see how we can make use of the data item to pass these values in the calc stage. So basically we need two more data items. This time I'm not going to drag and drop them. Instead, I can double click on data item from the toolbox, and for each click on the canvas, one data item will be created. I'll double click the data one, set the data type as number, and then type the initial value as 3. We'll talk about initial value and current value shortly. For now, I'll leave the current value as blank and click OK. Then I'll double click data two, set the data type to number, the initial value to 2, and click OK. Now I'll double click the calc stage, delete the current expression, then drag data 1, add a plus sign, and drag data 2. So we are telling Blue Prism to add the values in data 1 and data 2 and store it in the data item sum. I'll click OK, and now when I click the reset button, you can see that the value of data 1 is set to 3 and data 2 is set to 2. Also note that the value of sum is now blank or null. This is because when you click the reset button, all the data items will load their initial values. That's the reason why the value of sum, which was 5 before, changed to blank when we clicked the reset button, because we left the initial value of sum as blank. All right, so let me save this process. Then click the play button and you can see the addition worked. You can go ahead and change the values of data 1 and data 2. I will change the value of data 1 to 100 and data 2 to 200. And when I click reset, the initial values are loaded. And when I click the play button, the two values are added and stored in sum. Now let's add one more calc stage. We will use this calc stage to divide the resulting sum by the value in data 1 and store the result in data 2. So I'll double click the calc stage and name it as division. This time I'm going to type the expression instead of dragging and dropping them from the right. Now if I click validate, I get the error, your expression does not appear to be valid, missing data sum. I click OK, and when I check the canvas, I still see sum there, and it also has the value 300 in it. So why am I getting this error? It's because in Blue Prism, data items are case sensitive, so you need to type the exact case. Here in sum, S is in uppercase, and I typed in lowercase. So I'll correct it, and if I click validate again, I got the next error, which says missing data 1. It is again the same problem. I have used uppercase D when I created the data item, while in the expression I used lowercase d. Blue Prism will continue to throw this error until we fix them all. So the best way to avoid these errors is by using the drag and drop functionality. There is another way to build the same expression. I can simply go to the functions and under number, select the divide function, and you get a function builder on the right hand side. Now drag and drop sum into operand A and data 1 into operand B, then click paste and the expression will be created automatically. And I want to store the result in data 2, so I will drag and drop data 2 here. Now if I click validate, it says the expression is valid. You might be wondering what evaluate expression is. Let me show you. Evaluate expression allows you to test the expression with input data. By default, it picks the current value from the data items, but you can change them if required. I'll leave this right now and click test, and I got the result right. This is really helpful when we have a complex expression to be evaluated. Okay, so I will close this window and click OK to update the Calc Stage. Now, I would like to add this in between addition and end. I can delete this link and create a new link from addition to division and another link from division to end, but you really don't have to delete this link. Instead, just create the new links and Blue Prism will automatically delete the link between addition and end. Now I will reset the process and click the play button. Alright, so now if you notice data 2, the value changed from 200 to 3. This is because the initial value was set to 200, but after the two calc stages, it changed to 3. Now instead of doing these two calculations in two different calc stages, let me show you how to use a multi-calc stage. I'll drag and drop a multi-calc into the canvas, double-click on it, and rename it as addition and division. My first calculation will be to add data 1 and data 2. So I'll drag data 1, put a plus sign, and drag data 2. If you want the expression builder, you can click this button. For now, I will close it. Then drag and drop sum into this. Then I'll click add and input the second calculation, which is dividing sum by data 1 and storing it in data 2. When we run this, Blue Prism will execute the calculations one by one starting from the top. I'll click OK. Then link the start and end to it. But you will see the link between division and end is not broken. This is not a problem. The process will still work fine. That's because logically, if you think about a process, you can end the process through different paths, though not at the same time. So the end can have multiple incoming paths. As a matter of fact, most of the stages here can have multiple incoming paths, but only one outgoing path. You'll understand this better when we discuss about the decision stage in the later videos. For now, let me start the process by clicking the play button. Alright, so you can see that the final output is exactly the same as we got before, but we didn't see it happening in two steps like before because both these calculations are done within the multi-calc stage. This means that when you have multiple calculations to be done in a sequence, it is always better to use multi-calc stage because it is faster. Now let me save this process and add a comment. In the next video, we will discuss about the decision stage.